Say hi to Lisa. See, I came into Kinder for Rescue, and I was having, I think, heat stroke. Some idiot left me out somewhere. I don't know where. But now I'm feeling much better. Mary! And this crazy lady that runs this place named me Mary. My name's Mary.
Say hi.
In the quiet solitude of my thoughts, I find myself drawn back to that fateful day when a little bundle of joy entered my life, changing it forever. I saw my first picture of her 6 years, 9 months, and 24 days ago, but those numbers hardly capture the depth of the bond we shared. A serendipitous encounter brought us together when I adopted her after she was found wandering the streets, a lost soul seeking a home.
Murphy, I understand, I get it. Sammy, no. No, stop licking her. Oh, you're so mad.
And from the moment she nestled into my life, she carried a name that held profound significance. She was named after my dad, a symbol of the love that connected us all. From the very start, it was evident that she saw me as more than just a human companion. She truly believed I was her mother. She showered me with a love that only a devoted child could offer, and in her eyes, I found an unconditional devotion that left me humbled and amazed. Sam shared her life with a sister named Murphy, and their bond was nothing short of remarkable. In an act of pure maternal instinct, Sam lovingly groomed Murphy, and in return, Murphy nurtured her like a mother, a tender exchange of affection that brought joy to my heart. She became my ever-loyal shadow, her presence a constant reminder of the love that bound us together. Her favorite place was by my side, and she would find the coziest spots on my shoulders, face, head, or the palm of my hand, a testament to the comfort and security she sought in my touch. But her voice was a curious enigma, a bark cleverly disguised as a howl, a symphony of sounds that filled our home with laughter and warmth. And during car rides, she would perch on my shoulders, her eyes alive with wonder as we embarked on adventures together, her trust in me unwavering. As the day drew to a close, bedtime was her favorite time of all. After a small treat, a precious moment when we'd snuggle up together, her tiny heartbeat nestled next to mine, as Murphy was sometimes the small spoon, a melody of peace, snoring and love that echoed through the night. But life, in its mysterious and unpredictable way, had other plans for Sam. The day arrived when I had to confront the painful decision to let her go. She was in pain, and though my heart shattered, I knew it was the most compassionate choice for her. As I sat by her side, holding her close, I kissed her little face and whispered the words she had heard 1,000 times before. "You're just a baby." In that moment, time stood still. The world outside blurred as I held her and waited for the inevitable. Finally, the moment came, and as tears flowed like a river, I gently placed my hand on her chest, feeling her last heartbeat, a heartbreaking symphony of love and farewell. In that moment, my best friend slipped away, leaving an emptiness that words could never fill. But in the vastness of my grief, I find solace in knowing that she was loved beyond measure. Sam, the pug who thought I was her mother, had etched her paw prints on my heart forever. Her memory stays on in the whispers of our shared moments, in the love she gave so freely, and in the tears that bear witness to a friendship that transcended time. For Sam, my beloved pug, was not just a pet but a soul who touched my life in ways words can never express. And though she may be gone, her legacy will continue in the memories we shared, in the love we had, and in the tears that flow freely for a friendship that will endure even beyond this world.
Thank you. loud.